Hello, boy! It's an early access game! It's an early access game! Enemies were put in like a couple of days ago or something. I don't know.
Oh.
Man, that's better than how Link wakes up in Wind Waker, though. He wakes up to a creepy little girl. Although this generic music is a little too present. Game on, I think I'm gonna... after I get the power to skip out of main, turn on a sound of it, because it's a little loud for me. Oh, is this boy wearing jeans jacket with jeans? No, those aren't jeans. Jeans don't have baggy pockets like that. Those jeans would be good instead of bad. Yeah, it's a little bit better. Yeah, you can change your character. Who would you like to be? I would like to be the one that actually has some sense of fashion. Even if she's very lopsided. Look at that. You've got red, very red on top. And then you've got this odd white-blue transition to skin color and then brown. That is not a good color scheme, madam. Ooh! Do you remember the days when you did this a whole lot? And you did it with the C? With the C? Man! I remember the C buttons. I still wonder what the heck the N64 controller was even remotely about. Have you ever seen the N64 controller? That it has three of those plugs. One has the control stick, and both have all of them. Actually, all of them are shoulder buttons. You have the L and the R button, then you have the Z button. That's where the Z button comes from, by the way. The Z button was entirely invented to sit on the back of the N64 controller. So you had the buttons. Then you had the A, B buttons, in the usual place. Then you had a grid of 2x2, which were the C buttons, which went up, down, left, right. Used in Clover as cheat code input on the menu, which is really nice. Little detail, just a little baby detail to get y'all excited about the potential future Clover playthrough. That's never gonna happen. Oh, wow. That is a slightly odd jump. In that, I don't know, the momentum is a bit off, but it's better than, you know. Like, either keep it level or make it go higher, because if it goes up a little baby bit, it feels a little off. Although, on the other hand, it does mean that if you can just make it, you can just make it. Actually, they got decent sounds for the pickup stuff. I think I'm going to mess with the sound a bit more. I keep forgetting that my mouse isn't actually plugged in. So I'm going to turn it down a bit more. So I have some more control over audio. I'm going to turn up the SFX a bit. This reminds me of Mario Sunshine. Mario Sunshine had a lot of ropes. Man, it had so many ropes. You could do stuff with ropes, though. A new record. Why are you standing on that stump, old man? Is there something that's cool about that stump? Why is your important item just a medal? Are you that... Oh, he's that kind of guy. Oh, look at this. Are you a Naruto? You look like a Naruto. He looks a lot like a Naruto, doesn't he? He looks like that kid with the eye that goes all the time. And then it's like, I'm going to take this super bad deal because it's a smart idea. Even though it's a super bad deal. Oh, come on. Come on, if you do this, you have to put something here. It can literally just be an Easter egg item that says, hey, you got here. Or just a coin, you know? Validate my exploration. How did he get here? You were the one that sent me here. Wow. That's a giant compass. And actually a pretty good spotlight. Ooh. Now that looks... I'll give him one thing. That's really enticing to see, like, right out of the blue, like a huge sparkly in the distance. And the spotlight's a bit odd, though. So how do you fly this thing? It doesn't really look like it's powered or, you know, it just looks like a hunk of wood with some ornaments.
Oh.
Arr. How did you lose? They're pretty big. I'm surprised you lost them at all, dear sir. Sure. I have to say, this game just gets in it, doesn't it? Even Banjo-Tooie had a lot more cutscenes before you got going. Look at us. We already got a collectible thingy and a couple of money bits. And we're already on a flying ship. Couldn't say that about... Actually, I think Banjo-Kazooie was a little bit slicker on the uptake. Banjo-Tooie, on the other hand, ugh, just drowning in sequelitis. Ugh. You had upgrades that did one thing. You had upgrades that literally replaced existing upgrades. Like the drill ground pound is just like, oh, we didn't want to get rid of all the moves. Oh man, that game though. Banjo-Tooie has so many problems, and I still like it more because it had a lot more going thematically. I love how it's constantly reminding us that this is early access. Why can't I just... Why can't I change who I am? Like that. That's kind of odd. Well, I got a roll. Man, that's a Banjo-Kazooie roll if I ever saw one. In that, it feels a little bit faster than walking, and it's relatively easy to... Oh, man, that's... That's about as Banjo-Kazooie as you can get. The other buttons don't seem to do anything. Hello? Oh, wow. We got the looky button. And we got the camera reset button. That's a good looky button, because you don't have to hold it. You can, but you don't have to. Aw, we can almost ski. Aw, the world's called Poi. Normally, the character... Normally, in these old exploration games, they're named after the characters. So excuse me for thinking that Poi was the... I guess it would be weird if you can change characters. When did that happen? When did I sign up? Well, it doesn't matter. It's a little broken. Don't worry about that probably important navigation tool. It doesn't work right now. Don't worry about it. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. Let's go. That's a pretty... If that's a level select screen, I think it's cute. Aw, man. That's Mario. Which I think is a little dumb. I preferred the Banjo-Kazooie system of just do whatever you want for as long as you want, and then you can go home. I don't know. Something just rubs me the wrong way when you have to go in and out of the level all the time to pick the new missions. Although this place, I'll give it one thing. It's got a nice palette, but it's not too bright, you know? Like, it's got a good selection of colors. But it's not burning my eyes out, which is important. Because if your color palette is too bright, then people are like, wow. Ow. Oh, that's the ow guy. Did it just give me an achievement for harassing someone? It did! It gave me an achievement for harassing the carrot man. Oh, you can jump on him too. Wow, we're getting all the cool rules. We can roll into them and jump on them. Although jumping... Oh, okay. Double jump makes it a little bit easier, it seems. Nope. I'm not even going to try it. Jumping is a gambit. Jumping is a gambit. Look at this giant Mario spring. Although, that doesn't look springy. Put some hinges on it. Put some hinges on it. Because that just looks like a... Actually, that's how springs work, isn't it? They're just stiff bits of metal. Okay. Okay, he just decided to go home. Oh. Oh, if this was... it can do what it... Okay, no. I was thinking that it would make the rope pull taunt, but it's a power cable, not a rope. Should have been a rope. Oh, okay, you can't roll into that guy. What a Dark Souls thing to do. First death. Thank you, Dark Souls. Thank you, Dark Souls. Gonna have a look around. Is the thing still... Okay, no. It's those kind of rules. What is with that arrow? What is with that arrow, carrot man? I don't think your arms can do anything, really. How do you dive? Can you dive? Does this game feature the advanced diving... Ooh. Ah, that's neat. That's cute. Wait, does she have a that... Oh, she does. I really like that about Witcher. In The Witcher, you see, Geralt would do a little dive sometimes. When you go... He doesn't do it all the time, because for some reason my Witcher 3 playthrough is the most glitchy playthrough possible, and it's awful. How many coins have I picked up? Or keys, I mean. Oh, okay, I didn't get to keep any of my keys. Nope, I got to keep none of my keys. That's rude. Oh, there's a treasure chest down there. I want to pick that up. How do you open this thing? There you go. You just push the button. Okay, here's a tip. If you have steps like this, and you use those, here's a tip. Make a common stair height. A lot of games, like, look at Ratchet and Clank. You have the Insomniac Museum. In the Insomniac Museum, there is an entire arena built to test Ratchet's motion. This is important because if you want to use steps or slopes or any kind of particular terrain, standardizing terrain heights is important and can really help you out in the long run. So do those leaves just pop out whenever I go to a cool place? Because that'd be neat. That'd be awfully spiffy. Oh, those goo guys. Oh, it's a giant screw! I need a oh no, it's an X, I guess. I need a shovel to dig up the X. This reminds me of something. That it has this particular sort of rotating squares thing going on. This game is nice. I kind of feel that the jumping is a little too... you stick to your motion a little too much for the kind of combat it wants to encourage. Like, you can't have jump on things if jumping towards things is easy, but jumping on things is not. On the other hand, though, you always have to make that compromise of... Oh, wow, you can wall jump. That's neat. A lot of ways to handle wall jumping. A lot of ways to handle wall jumping. And I think this one does the you can only wall... Nope. This one does the either you can only wall jump per wall once. No, it just does it cleverly. I don't know how that works, but it works. It stops you from chain jumping, which is a huge concern, and possibly the reason they didn't actually. I think Mario let you do it, it just didn't. It wasn't possible. So what are these Koroks doing all over the place? Oh, wow. If I ever did see a most standard of platforming challenges. Although this is pretty stiff up there for the first mission. All things considered. What's this? It's something, and there's a button. I assume we'll be going there later. What's that? Is that a baddie? Oh, it's a snail! Oh, look, this little cutie! Oh, look at him. Oh, he's so cute. I'm gonna step on his head. What a cutie. He got stomped on. That ought to teach him, being a nice old snail man in the middle of nowhere. You can't skip this. Could you skip things back in the N64 days? I don't know. I think back in the day, people just didn't care. They just couldn't care. There's clearly something amuck with those things. I wonder if fall damage is a thing. Probably isn't. Because usually when games have fall damage, they have more variable height, more variable health than just one. Just three, you know? Like, if you're going to have fall damage and you only have three hit points at the beginning, that's a bit steep. That's a bit stiff. Bit of a hard ask. So can I just jump on your head and kill... Okay. Okay, so they're double hits. That's neat. You're gonna need the tough guys to be tough guys. I will say, though, I'm having a blast just walking around. I feel a bit slow. I feel maybe a sprint is in order, or something along those lines. But the speed is alright, though. Like, it's not slow enough that it bothers me, but it is slow enough that I notice it. And that's good enough. That's the kind of speed you want. You know? Oh, it's a fox! Come here, fox! Yeah! I showed him a good old-fashioned what for. This looks really nice. Okay, like, it looks really nice, like I said. Like, the color palette is just washed enough. Which, by the way, is a lesson I still have to learn as an artist. Probably never gonna happen, considering that I'm not having drawn in a while. Probably won't ever again. Unless it's for a stream for some reason. If I can get things out of order, that's great. I love it when you can get things out of order. I guess the reason you have to do one at a time is because they want a leaderboard of some kind. Come off and take a look! I bought this new blanket! Would you like to see it? It's purple! Ooh. I just love it when the excuse is, I need the money. Makes it easier to navigate levels. I love those. I love... Okay, so you can buy hearts. That's cool. Don't call it heart... Nah, heart container's fine. I don't think anyone can do that. Perhaps never on coins and collectibles. I think I'm going to buy the shovel. Because I've seen a bunch of shovel stuff. Big spender. Okay, so that's what the triggers are for. Get going, explorer. Get out of my hair and get me money. I said get me... if I had one coin more. Let's go use the compass. Thank you. What a nice man. What a nice man. Ah, Aw, I love this. That is Super Mario 64 as heck. You got one on the one side, and you got all the ones you didn't get in the middle. That is such a, you're going to get all this at some point. Oh, I almost forgot. Take my Explorer book. You already have this, but I just thought I'd remind you. We got to find the Fox Cave, the Super Space... Wow. That's exciting. That sounds... sounds like there's a lot to do. Okay, so it said we can swap this. What does the compass do? Oh, it literally just shows me a compass. So that's where the airship is at. That's where a dude is at. That's nice. Also shows me all the keys are at, but I don't care about the keys. What's this blue majigger? There's a blue majigger over here. There's a blue majigger up there. I want to touch the majigger. What'd it do? Hello there, carrot man. I can't dig here. You found a dig site. Stick your shovel in there and see what comes out. Oh, cool. Might want to give old Mr. MacGuffin a good old-fashioned twack on the head for not paying me enough for last time's game. Wasn't that one up there? Yeah, there was one up there. I wish I could use that shovel to twack some people. Aw, dusty shell. Ooh, let's grab. I thought it was just ledge climb, but it's ledge grab too, it seems. How sophisticated is this ledge grab? Wow. Wow, you know, it was cute when Mario did it like that, because, you know, he was a cartoony character, but it feels a little bit awkward when the person looks human enough that it's like, wow, how do you do that without your legs literally breaking apart? Oh, damn, I just want to grab the ledge and see how the sliding works. Okay, you can, okay. Okay, so... No dribble jump. Oh! Okay, I want to do that. Yep. Classic platforming. Is that for doing all of them? Do a triple jump. That's good enough. Strange yellow power wire. It's almost like the strange yellow power wire is powering something. Or maybe it's just a wire. Who knows? I'm a carrot. I don't understand anything. What is a stuffed pop? You can't just... By the way, one quick thing. It would be kind of cute if you could look at them after you've collected them. You know? Because you do have models for them. At least make me look at the model and be like, hey, I picked this up and it looks kind of cute. Although that means that you probably are going to have to detail them a bit more. Wow. This guy's not giving me any slack, is he? He's like, heck no. Music's a bit forgettable, though. I want to dig up these mysterious things. Oh, I picked up a thing. Okie doke! That's what the caves are for. But I can't go in there yet. I don't see any method of doing so. Fox, you did this. You're going to pay for it. Fox, you're the one that did this. There's little paw prints on the ground. Maybe I need something else. Let's just do the mission I'm supposed to be doing. That's a good roll, though. Like, considering most rolls are just these flat on the face rolls, this looks a lot better. It looks like a legitimate, this is how a person would roll, instead of how a cartoon character would do it. You know? Because it's really stupid to actually try and roll on your head. You're going to hurt your head. And it's going to hurt a lot. I need something that can light fires. I like that little arm spread. Like, whoa, look at me. Look at me. I'm fancy. You'll never catch me alive, old man. Once I buy all your tools, I'll steal my money back and make a run for it. Because money is weightless in most games for some reason. Wowie kazowie! I activated the windmill! Wow. That guy looks like a rude business. I love when he says, has it ever failed to activate? I don't know! Oh man, old man. You are probably gonna be the death of me. Let's try out this new tool. Let's go and die! Ooh. Sir, I got caught in your ship. Why do you have two ships? One wasn't enough, was it, old man? One just wasn't enough.
Hey.
Whoa, that's cool. Ooh. Oh, that looks Mario Sunshine as heck. At least the grid does. As does that. Let's go see the puzzle tower. Let's go have a good old-fashioned time. You know, it's fine to mimic old things. It's fine to take inspiration. But try to give it your own touch, you know? Give it that old college try to make it feel like your own thing. Like, even if you're just trying to cash in, giving it a little bit of your own charm generally... Oh, wait, there's a skip button that I missed that's at the bottom. How does one climb this thing? Oh! That's an important thing to learn. You can ledge grab like a boss. Okay, so fall damage isn't a thing. Restart. If we're gonna do this, we're gonna do it right. Ah, oh, darn it. I can do this. I just have to believe in myself. This song reminds me a bit of, what's it called? Trine. Trine had a very, bell and a sort of a fairy fancy song to it. Dude, don't be rude. What a rude, rude beaner. Oh! Looks like she's wearing a life jacket. She should be wearing fingerless gloves to sort of balance out the fact that her legs look a bit off. Color-wise. Wow, look at that leaderboard. Wow, it's nighttime now.
Hey.
Back with more coin. You wanna go? I wanna see how your slides are gonna work out. I always did love that level in Mario 64 with the big slide. Didn't like the water level that they tried to emulate in, No, they had, like, a lot of secret levels, that were like the boom, 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 boom. Those all sucked in Sunshine. They were all really awful. Some of them probably were nice, but most of them... tended to feel very... Ugh. Oh, we're gonna have to collect all the keys, huh? We're gonna have to MLG Pro... Oh, this looks very awkward. I hope my collection range is large enough, or I'm gonna have to buy some keys. I always love it when you can sort of backtrack. Oh, 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 oh. You got it. Yes, I get it. Not my old man. He can't do anything. Deus Volt. What a champ. We got Norm the Genie and Dave Scrammer. Now I have to go on top of the airship. By the way, if you're going to have this like this, where you just fly... I guess still would be kind of weird. Should be maybe look a little bit more like a hang glider. Because it looks a bit awkward that a parachute works like that. God, why is the Naruto here? Well, sure, kid. Sure, kid. How about we do one more regular level? This time we're just gonna book it. We're gonna book it. Explore 3 caves. Ah, they're gonna do this thing. One thing I never liked about Mario, about Galaxy in particular, Galaxy really pushed that more than any of the other. Actually, so did Sunshine. I guess Sunshine's the one I should blame. I don't like it when they arbitrarily decide, no, you can't do this mission right now, even though I did another mission earlier, and it just feels a bit awkward. It feels very, we don't have any trust. It's harder to test and harder to do, I know, but, you know. I want all the things. I got Big Rock Cave. And that's a fancy looking button. Oh! These buttons just make things happen. And they have give you a nice little, you did this thing. So that you know you did it. You did it, you did it, you did it, yeah, yes you did it, you did it. Oh, beaners. Who knew snails were my mortal enemy? As are dudes with buckets on their head. Now I found the steep cliff cave. Whoever names these places should get a new job. Because Asgore can do it for him. Wait, is the rolling jump a thing? Fox Cave. The only reason we call it Fox Cave is because of fox paw prints are right outside. The actual fox lives in Denver. You're gonna put in a triple jump. There's really nothing stopping you from putting in the crouch backflip jump. Ah, frick, it lets you do another. Can I buy something? I think I can buy that. Oh, look. Oh. Oh, so that's how that works. That's cool. I guess it's to compensate for the otherwise lacking jump techniques. The mystery of the lighthouse. Well, I do love a good lighthouse. Hello, Naruto. Hide out in his own treehouse. I'm sorry, but I wouldn't have the faintest clue where to look for the kid. Can't bump into things. Oh, this magnet is actually pretty good. A lot of water. And a lot of bees! What are bees doing here? What are you doing here? Well, those things look weird. Wait. Wait just one diddly-darn second. I see you! You don't get away from me, Naruto! Get down here, Naruto! How do I get Naruto to come down? Oh, that's how. That's it. Is that a garbage bag? Oh, no, it's a turtle! Yeah. Oh, nice. Hide and go seek. Welcome back, Explorer. It's night. Ooh. Let's go to this extremely dangerous place that probably will kill you, but don't worry about it. You live! I said I would do that mission, so I'm going to do that mission. And maybe we'll beat the whole level, because there's only like two left. Only one left, so how about we just do them all? Let's give it our A game. I can't believe that Naruto was keeping a medallion. He does know that medallion belongs to the old dad guy, right? He does know that, right? He does know that, right? If that Naruto doesn't know that, he's gonna get a big old kick on his Naruto butt. He's gonna know exactly what it feels like. It's a new record! I'm number 14?! Wow. There's Scrammer again. And go buck a fuffle. Oh, that guy's got guts. Guy's got guts. I'll never listen to you, old man. You'll never be my father, or my father's father's father, or me. Let's go see the Naruto. Maybe next time. Until then, I'll be right here, reminding you of your lost youth. Oh, we still gotta find some fossils, don't we? I guess we might as well do that right now. A fractured fin. Hello, old man.
Hello.
Hello. Still missing one. Oh, wow. Those look Mario Sunshine as all heckers. As all peppers. Okay, so it just seems to go by some sort of angle. Like, you had these weird spinning shells in Mario Sunshine. They make no sense whatsoever. Yeah! I got all of them. I'm still missing the golden boy and an unknown component. Oh, man. There's the golden boy. Fun fact, I had no idea what the word boy meant while I was playing. There are tokens in Spider-Man 2. And in Spider-Man 2, I did not know what boys were. So when I found the boy tokens, I was like, what is a boy? Ooh. I found another ancient Chinese cigarette. Still don't know what that airship... Oh. It's just that our airship is literally floating around. Huh. I say we still haven't seen everything. Oh. I love how sneaky you can get. That's one thing I just cannot appreciate in a lot of modern Nintendo games, is they are so into the concept of linearity and, but you can't do that, and this game just lets me do whatever I want. Get lost, game. I do what I want. I'm the big boy here. What was, oh, that's awesome. The little snail do makes coins when you stand on him. He's like, hey, you're helping me with my arthritis and my back problems. Here's some money. I'd love to help this old man out with his back problems. What an odd place to use your, lose your part, though. In this extremely N64 angular cave. One thing is that the water looks so out of place. Like, quality-wise, it's so much better. Then again, water usually is just a bunch of effects. Whereas most actual in-world things are, like, a whole bunch of... Okay, it is very specific on where you have to hit things. It is uber specific on that. On the plus side, I get to keep most of my things. So you need to hit them dead on, or it's your game over, kid. Yeah. You hit them game dead on, or it's game over, yeah, for you. Good to know. This game is fine. Like, it could use some better music. Like, otherwise, I'm having a good time, but the music is really the standout, not that good part. I mean, if Drawd can get a good soundtrack, then certainly so can you. I love that glitch. I'm gonna exploit the living daylight out of that one. I'm gonna go to Mars! Goodbye! I literally went to the moon. Well, color me sizzle, Fritz. I went to the moon! Which does not actually have moon gravity. How is the moon not a location on the locationator? I'm still missing one. And there's another thing to get. I wonder what that is going to be. Pull out my... Where did the ship go? Oh well. I'm sure you don't mind. Huh. Go say hello before I decide to eat him. He looks mighty tasty. Goodbye, Naruto. I like how all he has is this spaceship. Give me a moment. Those things had interactables. Were interactables. I think this is a very interesting way to take to make a hub world. Surely it ain't the best way to do it, but oh look, look. A little prompt. I wonder what the prompt was. Read. Oh, so that's how the so that's how you get the thing. Whoop. For some reason, you can just cancel it whenever you want. You can't use a telescope while you're flying through the air like you just don't care. That's dangerous. This is better flying than Skyward Sword, which is says a lot about how terrible that flying was. It was not great. Oh, come on. I just wanna go over there. I got stuff to do. Collect 100. That's actually not a bad idea, but in the original, in most Mario games, they don't tell. That's one thing, though, is the Mario games never actually told you that was a thing you could do. Yeah, the last location appears to be a super secret. Kind of neat that the ship's flying back there. So collecting 100 coins. Yeah, there's another bleepity bloop on my bleepity blapper. Oh, that's one thing. I think it was Mario Sunshine or Mario 64. One of the two had notoriously hard to get 100 collectibles. Because for whatever reason, they thought it was 100% A-OK to just be very, very, very skimpy on that. Gotta look for coins, kid. Your mission? Make me rich! Like how the treasure chests don't respawn. Also, if you're going to include 100 collection missions, that's going to severely impact your in-game economy system. Location around here somewhere. I'm getting just my head flipped turned upside down. Also, because I'm not quite sure if the compass works in relation to my character or in relation to my environment, to my character or the camera. Oh, it's the bird, isn't it? It's the bird. It's the frickin' bird. Flappy bird. Not 100% behind that joke, but whatever. You do you. Let me tell you about them kids and why they shouldn't be doing themselves. Oh, I do like this, though. I do like games that do that, where it's like, oh, you've done the thing. Now the thing is forever unlocked. I remember in 64 being like, oh, I need to get a coin, drop a coin, drop a coin. Because for some reason, I couldn't... Wow, I got my complete... just got myself flipped turned upside down. I remember that there were, at some point, some enemies would respawn and they would not carry a coin, even though they did before, to sort of stop coin duplication, I guess. Even though there is a guy who discovered how to coin duplicate, and then there's the whole, oh, but you can only have so many coins at once. Man. Once you start getting fancy, things get really complicated. That sounded like someone just tore everything apart in a single go. Which is not healthy. You shouldn't tear everything apart in a single go. I like how it's apparent that... I like how apparent it is that these kinds of games, I can do super good. Or at least I'm competent at them. Because it's just to move the guy around, you know? You have a good old-fashioned time. I should have been an acrobat. Although that class pretty much isn't great! Boop-a-dip, boop-a-dip. You know, to make it more clear that you can only jump on them, you can do a bit of visual language, like putting spikes on their sides. You know, spikes, the universal indicator of please do not touch this thing, or it will hurt you. So universal, in fact, that... That's a good climbing animation. So much so, in fact, that Crash Bandicoot basically made an entire game, made an entire series that was just that. Hit him from the side or hit him from above. Ooh, there's a point there. Oh, is the idea that you wall jump him or what? Oh, that's cool. But I only need like a couple more. I wonder how it's gonna do this. Gonna do the old fashioned Mario 64 way? Where the coin appears right above your head? Nope, it's playing it safe. Because one giant problem with getting 100 and then it appears on your head is you can be riding down a one-way trip and it just gets stuck there. And you're kind of boned. You enter the bone zone. Also, this is a good climbing speed. There are some games that love just making you climb like a turtle. Yeah! I got all the widgets. And we gotta go visit the man and say, hey, I collected all the widgetmajus. Oh! Oh, the 100 coin. Okay, that is Mario as all heck. Because in Mario, guess what? 100 coin stars did not interrupt your adventuring tours. What now, old man? Oh. Looking for more explorer's tools. Looking for more explorer's tools? I've got nothing at all. I found all your thingamajiggers. Oh, that oh, that's cute. That's awesome. It's animated too. It's animated too. Here's a Wahidzits. Thank you. Right. I love Wahidzits and Wajubers. What a great reward. Fan flippantastic. Oh no, like a fish in a thing. Wait, what did that say? Oh, it probably said deploys retract sail, you know. Like if you're like in some games you're like, "Oh, I'm flying over it. How do I stop?" The stop button is an important button, just as important as the go button. Let's go have just a very, very, very... Oh, yeah, that's what it did. Okay, let's have a very quick look at this. Okay, so it's direct. How does this ship work? Would be kind of cool if the light thing changes color when it hits a thing. Tiny detail. All polish. It's polish. And polish tends to make an experience slightly more enjoyable. It adds that charm to something, you know? And like I said, charm is a big important part. I think this is nice. I have my problems, but generally speaking, it just needs polish. There's a good solid experience in there. Wow. That feels Hailfire Peaks, the wall in particular, with the repeating concept, and Super Mario 2, in terms of this is a tower with retracting platforms. But that's fine, you know. Those games are old. What person of... one thing I don't like is... I love it where you have this particular part you always have to do. But look at this adorable Darno man! Look at this guy! Oh, he's so cute. Oh, he's so cute. Look at this guy. Oh, he's so confident. Oh, look at how confident he is. He knows how to do it. He's a cutie. I like him. And he's a little belly button. Oh, did they do the Japanese thing where he has a butt too? Amaterasu had a butthole. Do you? I still can't believe they put a freaking butthole. On Amaterasu. I wonder if he's gonna get upset if I kill the Bucket Man. Wow. Let's pull out our thingamabobber. Let's not dig. Let's pull out our thingamabobber. Oh, so that's a toggle. Okay. Let's have a look-see. This is a good telescope. 10x zoom is a lot. So there's a metal over there. Oh, you can see him flickering from distance. That's cool. Oh, man. I'll be honest. I loved Rusty Bucket Bay in Banjo-Kazooie. Big on my list. Okay, so apparently it's getting a little bit looser with the rules now because I can collect a completely different metal now. Let's look at it a little bit. Oh, that's cute. It's a little cloud. Little cloud. That's cute. Gotta have a good design for your coins because there's a lot of them. Yeah. I don't think I can see too well from here. Yeah, there's a whole bunch more over there. Ooh. So next time, we're gonna go complete our Google Maps collection, I guess. And harass this bone man. Wait, what? I can dig here? But don't worry me, I'm just letting this magic fart gas rejuvenate my skin. Magic fart gas! And animation's flipping out! Or the camera flipping out, at least. Love it when the camera flips out. Ooh. What do you have to say, dude, about all this green fart gas? I'm gonna dig up your fire, sir. Only I can prevent forest fire, sir. Only I.